Hi, welcome to Era e-learning. Today we are going to learn how to create purchase requisition for the services in S4HANA SAP module. Starting with purchase requisition, as we discussed earlier during the purchase requisition for material, the purchase requisition is a requirement document or is a formal document which is issued to the buyer, and this document consists all characteristics required for buying of the material or the services on a specified date. Now, what are those characteristics? Those characteristics starts with type. In our case, we are discussing about services, so type is services. Next is category. So category of requirement, it can be one time or it can be repeated one. For repeated one, we are going to issue agreement or contract, or for one time, we are going to issue service PO. Now, scope of requirement. Scope of requirement is generally a document. In our general philosophy, we are saying it scope of work, where we define all the characteristics, terms and conditions, departmental specific requirements which we have to execute in the site, which we have to take care during the execution, which will be termed as a governing characteristics during the execution, will incorporate it in SOW, and SOW will be the reference document for the scope of requirement of the PR. Now, date of requirement. Date of requirement can further be segregated into two types. For one, that is standard PO, date of requirement is the completion date of the said services in the PO. And for the agreement or contract, date of requirement is the commencement date of the contract or agreement, or so called start date of the same. Now, valuation. Valuation will be the reference price, and account assignment. Now, there is a difference between the material PR and the service PR. In material PR, we can define call center or WBS as per your organization setup in the SAP, but in case of services, account assignment will be common for all the industries, and we have to specify GL account number in the account assignment as a mandatory field. Now, going forward, we are going to practice the same in the SAP. So here we have to use C code ME51N. You can also go with the navigation menu, logistics, material management, purchasing, purchase requisition, create. Now we have to select the document type. So in our case, document type is normal purchase requisition only. If you want to create, you can go with outline agreement. But in this case, purchase requisition only. So till that step, it was just similar to the material PR step, but now there is a difference. When you want to buy any services, you have to define the account assignment category in the line item. Here I am defining the account assigned category as a project. Since I am procuring for a particular part of services, that particular part of services will be part of a project, whether it is a minor improvement project, whether it is a MOC project, whether it is a long-term project, but it is a particular part of project, so I'm assigning to a project. Now, description of the job. Room repairing and painting, quantity 1, unit AU, delivery date is 30/1/2019. Material group, I have to select building part. So here, I'm selecting building, and plant is IETJ, purchasing group is IP. See, as we have discussed earlier, general ledger account is mandatory for the service PRs. So here in the bottom, you can see this enter GL account as a mandatory field is showing. Now we have to enter the GL number. So in our case, defined number is 100013002. Now you have to enter the valuation price. In our case, it is 98,000. All the details have been entered here. Now, if you want to check there is any error in your PR, you can press the check button here. System will issue a message. You can see at the bottom, no messages issued during check. It means your PR is ready for the
release. But before going for the release, I would like to tell you about one special function available in the SAP that is called text. Starting with the item text. Item text is a comment box in which whatever you are going to describe as a special requirement, special note, that item note means the text is going to appear in the PO, which will be further accessible for the vendors, and vendor will take that as a reference. So I'll give you an example, like room repairing and painting. Use skilled manpower more than 2 years. All those things are already going to cover in SOW. But in my case, in just want to give you a demo, so I've typed this requirement over here. I need to go forward. I just double clicked, so it has taken us to one format. So item text, you can describe anything. In material PR, we have forgot to add these all items. So I'm just describing you in this session. In material PR also, you can mention any of your specific requirement, any of your specific note here to the vendor. Next is item note. See, item text is going to appear in the PO for the vendors, but item note is not going to reflect in the PO. That is for the internal purpose only. You can describe here is required for SAP classes started in January 2019. So that is a specific note which I have entered here for my internal reference only. It can be termed as a reference for the releasing. It can be termed as a reference for the future. Delivery text is not here in the PR stage. We have to describe the same in the PO stage. In the SAP PO session, we are going to cover the same. And material PO text. See, material PO text for the material code generated in the system, in the material master, there will be a predefined material PO text over there. But since we have not maintained any material master for this generic item, since this is a services P, so material PO text is showing open for all. But in case if you have already created a material code in material master, this material PO text will be blocked for you in this tab. You can maintain the same using the material master. So now all these things have been covered here. You can see release strategy is already defined for this PR. Since we have entered the value, we have entered all the required details. Now we can go and save the same. See, I have created a PR for a generic activity, but I want to specify the particular services which we are going to execute in this PR. How to do that? We have taken a project PR, but there will be the individual services which we are going to execute into the room repairing. This room repairing is not a total room repairing activity. This is a room repairing activity pertaining to particular floor repairing and painting. I'm giving an example that this is a room repairing pertaining to the floor repairing and painting only. Rest all furniture and all job have been done by somebody else. How we are going to describe only these two activity in this PR? So it can be, it can have a equal and valid reference. And for the accounting purpose, for auditing purpose, everything, you should have a clear cut view that what activities you have performed in this PR. Or in case you are creating a service order for in the contract view or the agreement view, then further the services will be useful for you. Let me give an example. You will have a better understanding of the same. In my case, I am availing the services. Now, once you avail the services, system will open one more tab called services in the bottom. Earlier, when D was not here, the services tab was not available. But in this case, services tab appeared. Now you have to describe the services. Like, and here you have to describe enter. See, earlier when D was not there, we have mentioned a valuation price. But when we have inputted item category as services, service tab is activated over here. That in that case, valuation price cannot be taken from this valuation tab. We have to put the price here and it will be automatically captured as a valuation price for this PR. Now I need 10 man days of door repairing guy and 10 man days for the painter for executing this activity. Sorry, MDY is not created in the system. Error. So I can say I have to create. I will put the months. That is also not a problem here. Months I will take. So 1 month of this flow repairing person. Here I have to take GL account. As we discussed earlier, we have to mention. Now here also I have to take 1 month. MON my GL account. See, when earlier the item category services was not defined, the GL code is assigned to total service project. Total project. But in this case, since we have defined it, the item category as service based, service tab is activated. Now the GL code has to be allotted to the individual services we are availing, not the total project. So individual services we have taken, we have assigned the GL code. Now valuation C, it is 0. We have already discussed that valuation will not be captured from the valuation tab, it will be captured from the services tab. Now we have to describe the gross price. Like 1 day price for this floor repairing person is 800 rupees. Sorry, we are saying about month only. You say 15,000 rupees. Is estimated price. Enter. Now you can see 30,000 is captured here from that services. Now just save it. So our PR is saved now. We created a PR. We changed the service PR. Now this is the time to have a display view. This is the display view. You can also go to change view from display view by clicking over here. We have already defined the text note and item note and item text for this PR. Now going back, we have to release the PR. In order to release the service PR, we have to type ME24N, same T code which we use for the material service PR. So material PR, go to the release strategy and start to release. See, release indicator here showing as a blocked one. Now I have done the first release, second release, and third release. Now you can see the release indicator here. It is open for the RFQ and purchase order. Please note down, this first release is for the user, the person who is creating the PR. Second is for the HOD, it is my departmental HOD, and third is the store person who is going to deliver inventory. See, all this release strategy is defined in the SAP and all the roles have been individually assigned to the particular user IDs in your individual plants. In my case, this is a dummy system, so all these roles have been assigned to my ID. But in your cases, it will be assigned to the different IDs. So you cannot, the user cannot release for the HOD. HOD will be someone else. He has to log in into the system. He has to go in ME54N and he has to release the PR. Similarly, same thing has to be done by the store person also. We have forgot to mention the item header note here. Header note you can also mention here. According to SAP HANA process. Now you can see my purchase requisition for service is created and fully released from all the labels. At the bottom you can see purchase requisition 5×0, 42 is changed. And if you go bottom, the release indicator, it is open for the RFQ and the purchase orders. Now you will again have a look of ME5A. See, purchasing group, I will put IP. Good document. See, earlier we have created services for Sony camera RG. This 15×0 17 PR for material, and this time we have created one service PR for 15×0 42 for room repairing and painting of the same. So in this way, we are going doing all the activities for the PR by putting a procurement of the services and putting a procurement of the material.
Don't forget to click on like, subscribe and bell icon for the notifications. Thank you.